Okay, start. I'm recording this session. Ano? Today we're going to discuss chapters 10 and chapter 11 of the Nets. So, chapter 10 is about the liquid vapor equilibrium. Ano? Tapos chapter 11 is solution thermodynamics. Let me share the PowerPoint. Chapter 10 is about vapor-liquid equilibrium. So in this particular chapter, we're going to discuss the Reaulf's law, the Henry's law, equilibrium ratio. No? So most of this probably na-discuss nyo na sa, ano, sa physical chemistry. Okay, so we need to review some of the equation. So this is the Reaulf's law. If you remember the Reaulf's law, so it's P sub A is equals to X sub A. P sub A is the vapor pressure of a particular substance ano, over a solution. Tandaan nyo pa? P sub A. Tapos X sub A, right here. No? Right here. X sub A is the whole fraction of that particular substance A, you know? Whole fraction of substance A. Tapos, P sub A star, this is the vapor pressure over a pure solution, over a pure substance. Halimbawa, we are speaking A is, halimbawa, is ethanol, ano? So, if you still remember, P sub A star is the vapor pressure over pure ethanol at a particular temperature. Tandaan nyo pa? So, kung sa water naman, yung P sub A star, yun yung nakukuha nyo sa steam table. Halimbawa, di ba? Steam table, meron temperature, tapos may corresponding pressure, saturated. So, yun yun, no, that's also the Psat of water, P sub A star. So, I'm using this notation kasi ganito yung notation kay Atkins para medyo familiar kayo. Ano? Nare-recall nyo pa? So, syempre, pag solution, hindi yun pure, ano, hindi yun pure A. Meron siyang ibang substance. No? So, yung P sub A star, hindi yun yung mag-a-act sa solution. Kailangan nyo siyang i-multiply ng mole fraction para makuha nyo yung vapor pressure ng ethanol or ng substance A. Ano? Tandaan nyo pa Reaulf's law? So parang ano rin lang to, ano? Parang ideal gas law. No? So pag ideal gas law, may limitation din. Hindi palagang exact. So, halimbawa, ang ideal gas law, accurate lang siya pag mababa yung pressure. Ito naman, yung Reaulf's law, accurate lang to pag mataas yung X sub A. Tandaan nyo pa? The ideal solution. Tapos mataas yung X sub A. Yun, so, in terms of P, ibawa binary, we have A and B na solution. Solution is made up of substance A and substance B. Ibawa A is the solute, B is the solvent. So, ganun din, ano? Reaulf's law also applies to the solvent. So, P sub B is equal to X sub A times P star. Okay. And then, the total pressure over the solution is the sum of P sub A and P sub B. Y sub A is mole fraction.
baseball fraction at ligas pitch, ano? Twice a base na ball fraction. So by definition, y sub a is equals to gawa n sub a divided by total number of holes. Ano? Tapos, bakit dito, it's shown that ano, p sub, y sub a is equals to p sub a over p. Kasi when you assume that the paper phase follows the ideal gas law, so basically the ideal gas law is dp equals n r, so going to isolate n, n equals dp r. So pag sinubstitute natin dito yan, basically ang mangyayari, lahat magka-cancel out except for the prime. So halimbawa itong n sub a will become n sub a. Since they are occupying the same container, they occupy the same volume. Gas constant naman, syempre, gas constant. Tapos, they are in contact, so they have the same volume. Okay. Ano? So this is true, basta the gas follows the idea. Do you have any question? You're still familiar with this equation? We're going to use this equation to solve the problem. Do you have any question before we start? So let's try to solve example 10.1. So we're still, lima pa rin naman kayo. No? Example 10.1, consider a binary system, ano? So this is a solution containing two substances, ano? Hello. Hello. Hello, Jamie, okay na? Hello
po, sir. Parang yung background music niyo po yung medyo nalakas po siya, unlike po dun sa voice niyo po.
Okay na? What about that? Mahina pa rin? Hello? Jamie, mahina pa rin?
Ayan, sir, medyo okay na po.
So yung kanina so na-review lang natin yung equation, ano, first the Riolt's law, P sub A is equals to P sub A star. Ito, so nakuha niyo na naman to sa PCM, ano, so, kaya ni-review lang natin. So this is the vapor pressure of a particular substance, ano, a substance A over a solution. Tandaan nyo pa? Okay lang audio natin. Tapos x sub a is the mole fraction of a in the solution. P sub a star is the saturated pressure of a pure substance A. No? So, halimbawa, you have pure ethanol in a beaker, tapos minesure nyo yung kanyang vapor pressure. Yun yung P sub a star. So, as I've explaining kanina, yung nakukuha sa steam table
P-saturated yun ng ano, ng water. No, P sub H2O star yun ng water. Okay? So, imagine niyo pag we're going to mix two substances, no, in a solution. So, yung vapor pressure ano, bababa. Kasi dalawa na sila eh. Yung isang substance kasi parang mangyayari hilahin niya yung molecule ng isa para hindi mag-evaporate. No? Okay? Do you have any question regarding the Reaults law? Tandaan niyo pa to. And then yung sa halimbawa ito naman yung sa B, you know? So ganun din, you can apply Reaults law sa substance B. So P sub B is equals to X sub B times P sub B star. And halimbawa binary lang naman yung solution, dalawang substance lang. Yung sum ng P sub A at saka P sub B, yun yung total pressure over the solution. Okay lang? Can you hear me? Jamie, okay na ba audio natin? Walang problema.
Apo sir, okay na po.
Tapos ito, yung last equation natin, yung Y sub A is equals to P sub A divided by P. This is Y sub A is the mole fraction at the gas vapor phase. Ano? At the gas or at the vapor phase. So, ang ano niyan, ang simple definition niyan is Y sub A is equals to N sub A over N total. No? Number of moles of A divided by total number of moles. So if the gas follows the ideal gas law, IGL, ano, this is the ideal gas law. So nakita nyo naman dun sa derivation natin, magka-cancel out lahat, ang matitira lang ay P sub A over P. So pag ideal solution, you can use this equation, this last equation, ano, to calculate Y sub A. Okay? Do you have any question regarding this set of equation? Gagamitin natin to solve the first problem. Parang review lang naman to lang ano no ng PCM. So we have here example 10.1. So we have a binary system, acetonitrile and nitromethane, no? So they conforms closely to Reaults law, parang ideal solution sila, no? So we have here some equation. You're still familiar with Antoine's equation. So this is Antoine's equation, ano? Tandaan nyo pa Antoine's equation. Ito yung may A, B, C. So itong, halimbawa, itong 14.7, ito yung A niya. Tapos I think it's 2,945, ito yung B. Tapos itong 224, ito yung C. So dapat daw ang temperature is in degrees Celsius. Ano? Okay. So you are asked to prepare a graph showing P versus XI. Okay, and P versus Y sub I for a temperature of ano, 75 degrees Celsius. So basically what you're going to do is you just substitute this 75 degrees Celsius dun, no? Sa Antoine's equation. Dito pa, yung isa. No? Tapos you're going to calculate itong P sub I saturated, this is the same as P sub I star. No? So si ito kasi yung ginagamit ni Atkins. So ito na kaya ito pa rin yung ginagamit ko hanggang ngayon, ano? Ito yung ginagamit ni Van Ness, P sub I saturated. Pero parehas lang naman 'yan, ano? So basically makukuha niyo dito yung P sub I saturated from this equation, your calculator. So isa lang yung P sub 1 at acetonitrile sat at saka isa rin lamang yung P sub 2 sat, no? Tapos gagamitin niyo yung Reaults law, no? So mag-a-assume kayo ng X sub A. So, for example, magsisimula kayo sa X sub A is equals to 0. Okay? Gagamitin niyo yung Reaults law. Ganyan lang, ano? So makakalculate niyo yung P sub I. Tapos since binary lang naman sila, pag nandun na kayo sa X sub B equation, yung X sub B is equals to 1 minus X sub A lang. No? Halimbawa, 1 minus x sub a. So, p, x sub b is equals to 1. In short, makakalculate nyo rin yung p. Wala p a. Yun na. Makakalculate nyo rin yung p. Probably, this is better to be p. p2. No? This is p1. Probably p2. This is probably p1. Ganun, ano? And then, pag meron na kayong P1 and P2, you just add both and then you're going to get P. Okay, that, tapos pag meron na kayong total P, you can calculate Y1, for example, by dividing P1. So, ganun yung gagawin natin. Ano? So, let's try some ano, some values. Pala muna, solve muna natin itong equation. Ano? Let's try to find P1 sat and P2 sat. So, dito na lang. Ano? Let's just get your calculator. Do you have your calculator with you? So, try to calculate P1 sat and P2 sat. You can do this by substituting 75 degrees Celsius right here and 75 degrees Celsius right here. No? First one is 14.2724 minus 2945.47 divided by 75 plus 224. Okay? Tapos, let's get the anti-natural logarithm. Ano? So, I'm getting ano, 83.21 or P1 sat. Hope you're also getting that button. I guess this is in kilopascal. So, do the same thing for P2 sat. Tama? You're getting the value, no? 14.2043 minus 2972.47 divided by 75 plus 209 e raised to ans, I'm getting 42. I'm getting 42.01. The last time I get 41.9. Kayo, ano nakuha dyan? You agree with the values? Or 41.98 din yung nakuha? Kami mali ako na pinito. 14.204 minus Any question? So, with this, let's try to calculate some values. Ano? So, we're going to prepare a graph showing P versus XI or X1 and P versus Y1 at 75 degrees Celsius. Okay. So, first, ano, let's consider X1 is equals to 0. So, if X1 is equals to 0, let's use the Reolle's law and then we'll try to find Y1 and P, no? So, if x1 is equals to 0, then Riolle's law is t1 is equals to x1 times p1 sat. So if x1 is equals to 0, just like this one, p1 would be equal to, obviously, p1 would be equal to 0, 2. No? So, another equation is, siyempre, dalawa lang, binary lang, ano? So, binary lang kasi. So, ang another equation that we have is x1 plus x2 equals to 1. So, if this is equal to 0, kamukha nito, so, x2 is equals to 1. No? So, pag pumunta tayo sa second Riolle's law, p2 is equals to x2 times p2 sat. Okay? So, p2 would be equal to 1, x2 is equals to 1, right here. Tapos p2 sat, ito sat is yung 41.98 kilopascal. So p2 would be equal to times to, no? 41.98 kilopascal. Okay, so now we can calculate p. P is simply equal to p1 plus p2. So p is p1 is 0, and then p2 is 41.98. So p, total pressure is 41.98. Question? And then finally, let's try to calculate y1, this one, no? So obviously y1 is equals to p divided by p1 divided by p. The equation natin kanina, no? So substitute p1 is 0 here. Tapos p, yung total pressure is 41.98. So as you can see, y1 is equals to 0. No? And then total pressure is 41.98. Yun. Do you have any question? So basically, ulitin nyo lamang itong series na to, ang calculation to get the P and the Y1. No? So kamukha nung solution sa ano, so, gano'n siya, no? 0.2, y, X1 is equals to 0.2, another X1 is equals to 0.4, 0.6, 0.8, and 1.0. Tapos may value siya ng Y1, so pwede nyang i-graph yung X1 at saka Y1. Diba? Pwede niya rin i-graph yung x1 at saka. Okay? So probably we'll try another one. Let's try 0.2, no? Kasi sabi niyo, oh, baka pwedeng ano 'yan, no? Kasi puro zero lang yung. Let's try another one. Let's try 0.2. So, ganun din, ano, if x1 equals to 0.2, first we can calculate p1 equals to x1 times p1 sat. So p1 equals to 0.2 times p1 sat is 83.21 kilopascal. So p1 would be 16.64, ano? Kilopascal. Okay. Let's try to calculate x2. Diba ang equation natin? x1 plus x2 equals to 1. So if this is 0.2, so x2 would be equal to 0.8. No? Tapos, let's use the Riolle's law for component 2, p2 equals x2 times p2 is 0.8. Tapos P2 sat natin is 41.98 kilopascal. So P2 is 33.58. We can now calculate the total pressure. So the total pressure is P1 plus P2. So P is 16.64 kilopascal plus 33.58. So P is the same as this one, 50.20. More or less, ano, I'm getting 50.20. So more or less pares. 224. Any question regarding P? And then Y1. Y1 is simply P1 over total pressure. You know? So P1 is this one. Divided by 50.20. Are we going to get 0.313? Ano? Sakto naman yung Y1. Ano? This is also equal to 0.81. Do you have any question regarding this problem? So, tuloy nyo lang kung gusto nyo ituloy. Ano? Halimbawa, 0.4, 0.6. Questions? Kung walang question, let's proceed. Okay pa ba yung audio natin? So if we're going to plot X1 versus P, no, ito yung data natin kanina. If we're going to plot X1 versus P, we're going to get something like this. Ano? Itong curve na to. Itong nasa baba. Okay? So this is a pressure composition curve sa PCM nyo. Ano? Bay solution, ano? Bay binary solution. So, halimbawa, tingnan natin yung pag, ano, isip, naisip nyo naman, ano, pag mataas ang pressure, if we're going to increase the pressure, so generally, you will have a liquid. Pag mataas ang pressure, you will have a liquid. You will have a liquid solution. Kapag mataas naman ang, mababa lang ang pressure, so mag-i-evaporate yung liquid na yon. So, you will have vapor or superheated vapor. Sa baka, ano? So, liquid dun sa taas, tapos dito ay tapos kung natatandaan nyo pa yung PCM nyo, pag nandito sa loob, this is, ito yung pinag-connect lamang yung dalawang vapor pressure, ano? Dito, you have a mixture siya ng liquid at saka vapor. Dito sa loob, ano? Liquid vapor, tapos vapor. PCM, di ba? Tapos, yung point C, point C is the dew point, no? Kasi to vapor to. Tapos pag sinabing dew point, yun yung ano, mag-a-appear yung kauna-unahang drop ng liquid, ano? Dew point. Dew means hamog, 'di ba? Ang hamog ay liquid. Makakita na kayo ng hamog. At ang hamog. Yung hamog, 'di ba? 'Di ba yung halimbawa umaga, malamig, 'di ba makikita niyo sa bintana niyo may liquid water. Huh? Ibig sabihin nun, nag-condense yung moisture, yung water vapor sa bintana nyo. So, kaya dew point. Ano itong point C? Okay, so pag ano, pag tinaasan nyo pa yung pressure, maaabot nyo yung point B. Yung point B naman, liquid siya, tapos nag-appear yung kauna-unahang vapor. No? So ang tawag dito is the bubble point. Ito yung parang boiling point. Ano? Questions? Re-review lang natin ang PCM natin. Nakuha nyo naman sa PCM, guys. Itong ano, pressure composition diagram. Tandaan nyo ha, yung nasa taas ay liquid. Pag mataas ang pressure, liquid ang solution. Pag mababa ang pressure, vapor siya. Tapos sa loob, mixture yan ng liquid and vapor. Tapos, learn how to interpret yung dew point sa kayo. Bubble point. Don't have any. Let's proceed. Next, Henry's Law. So, ang pinapatandaan sa physical chemistry, pag sinabing the solution is ideal solution, ibig sabihin nun, it follows the Reaulds Law. Ah, Reaulds Law yun. So, kailan ginagamit ang Henry's Law? Ginagamit ang Henry's Law pag mababa yung exabate. No, dun siya ano, medyo relevant. Ibig sabihin, pag sinabing relevant, approximately true. Kasi these are ano, limiting law. So, ang Reaulds Law, totoo lang siya pag mataas yung X sub A. Ang Henry's Law naman, tama siya pag, pag mababa yung X sub A. So, that's why we have Reaulds Law and Henry's Law. And then, by convention, ang ideal solution follows the Reaulds Law. Wala naman binabanggit sa Henry's Law. Ano? Pero, pag nagsosolve ng problem, medyo yun, nakakalito yan. Pag nagsosolve ng problem, hindi sinabi kung Henry's Law yung gagamitin o kaya Reaulds Law. Pwede actually gamitin yung dalawa. No? Pero ako, sa Reaulds Law yung ginagamit ko kasi pag ideal solution, Reaulds Law yung default. No? Saka pag, sa another example, pag walang binigay na ano, Henry's Law constant, hindi mo rin pwedeng gamitin yung Henry's Law unless makikita mo sa handbook. Kaya lang hindi rin ganun ka-reliable. Ano? Unlike the ano, like the Reaulds Law, PSAT lang yung kailangan nyo. No? So yung PSAT, pwedeng gamitan nyo ng Antoine's equation, makukuha nyo siya. Reliable yung Antoine's equation. Ano? So, alam nyo naman kung nasaan yung Antoine's equation sa handbook, diba? Nasa distillation chapter. Chapter na ba? 13, ano? Of course, H is the Henry's Law constant. Tandaan nyo pa ang Henry's Law constant H, the Henry's Law constant. So basically, pag tiningnan nyo, parang napalitan lamang nyo yung PSAT, ano? Yung Henry's Law constant. Okay, so I think we're going to use Henry's Law in the problem. Apply this. So this is example 10.2. Assuming that carbonated water contains only carbon dioxide and water. Ito yung soda, ano? Hilig pa kayo sa soft drinks? Ito yung magpataba. Malakas magpataba. Soft drinks, ano? Isang buwan lang. Gawin yung tubig yung soft drinks nyo, lulobo kayo. Determine the composition of the vapor and liquid phases in sealed can of soda and the pressure exerted on the can at 10 degrees Celsius. Ano? So, Henry's constant for carbon dioxide in water at 10 degrees Celsius, malamig, ano? Usually malamig naman ang soda. It's about 990 bar. So, ito yung equation natin. Henry's law. Sub A is equals to H times X sub A. Halimbawa, we're considering carbon dioxide. May given kasi yung Henry's Law constant siya. So, sub CO2 is equals to 990 bar times XCO2. Kita nyo, ang pinapahanap sa atin yung composition. Kaya lang, kita nyo, dalawa yung unknowns. So, wala kayong choice dito. Ano? So, ang ginawang solution dito ni Vaness, nag-assume siya ng XCO2. No? Nag-assume siya nito. No? So, halimbawa, in-assume natin na ang composition, no? This is the mole fraction of CO2 in the liquid. When you say X, that's the mole fraction in the liquid. No? Tandaan niyo pa yung convention. No? Pag sinabing X, that's liquid. Mole fraction of CO2 in liquid solution. Okay lang. So, halimbawa, we're going to assume a value of XCO2 to be 0.01. if this is 0.01, ganito yung solution niya sa libro. Ano? If this is 0.01, simumultiply niyo ng 909, ilan ang magiging PCO? 909 times 0.01. So you're going, this is in bar, ano? 909 is in bar. 909 times 0.01, you're going to get something like PCO2 is 9.9 bar. Yung PCO2 na ito, yung 9.9 bar, yan yung pressure ng carbon dioxide na nag-a-act over the solution. No? Kasi PCO2 yan. Bawa, you have a glass. Tapos meron kang soft drinks dito, ano? Kaya bote na lang, ano? Kasi pag sinabing yung gas, open sa ano. Halimbawa, you have a bottle. Oh, it's a can. This is a can. It's a can of soft drinks. Ano? Can na lang pala. Ang mukha ng drawing. Close pa siya, ano? So, ito yung gas, ito yung liquid, no? Sa baba niyo. So, ibig sabihin nito, itong na-calculate natin, yung pressure ng carbon dioxide dito, PCO2 rito ay 9.9. Para yung composition sa liquid ng carbon dioxide, 0.6, whole fraction. Ganun yung ibig sabihin nun, ano? So, ang tinatanong sa problem is ano daw yung composition set ng liquid phase. So, ang composition ng liquid phase, 0.01 XCO2. And then the rest, yung 99, syempre ay question? Do you have any question? Sabihin nyo, oh, nag-assume ka lang eh. Actually, kasi kulang yung given niya. No? In-assume nyo lang to eh. So, kulang kasi yung given niya, kaya ganun yun lang yan. In-assume lang natin, and then kinalculate natin yung pressure sa glass. No? So, meron siyang given is 10 degrees Celsius. So, pag ginamit natin yung ano, pag ginamit natin yung steam table, tapos hinanap natin yung pH2O, yung H2O sat, at 10 degrees Celsius. Di ba makukuha natin to ano? Sa steam table. So, ang value ng H2O sat sa steam table ay 1.227 kilopascal. No? Kung ano naman kayong gumamit ng steam table, ano? 1.227. So pag kinalculate natin yung ano, yung pH2O, 'di ba? Pwede natin gamitin. O, halimbawa, using the Reaulds law, wala naman tayong choice. We're going to assume na saturated. So, halimbawa, using the Reaulds law, so we can calculate pH2O. Okay, so that pH2O sat times x sub a. X sub a natin is 0.99. Mumultiply lang natin itong dalawa, ano? So 1.227 k is times 10 to the 3 pascal. Gusto natin ano rin kasi. Gusto ko ano rin. Bar din, ano? So, di-divide ko ito ng 100,000. Can you follow? I'm just converting this to bar. This is pascal per bar. Tapos i-multiply ko siya ng 0.29. So, in this part, I'm using the Reaulds law, ano, to calculate pH2. So, kailangan ko kasi yung pH2O para makalculate yung total pressure, and then pag nakalculate yung total pressure, I can calculate YCO. Kamukha nung ginawa natin sa previous problem. So, anyway, so, ito bar na rin to, ano, pH2O, we have the value of pH2O. Can you follow? Sundan niyo ba yung mga pinagagagawa ko? Parang kamukha din ng problem kanina. So this is 0.0121, ano? pH2O is 0.0121. is in bar. So, to calculate the total pressure, makikita nyo, pag pinag-add yung dalawa, the total pressure is parang mga ano, 9.9121. No? So, since limited na yung space natin, let's try to calculate YCO2. YCO2 is this one, 9.9 divided by the total pressure. It's 9.91. So, YCO2 is ito yung composition. Ano? As you can see, most of the vapor is ano, made up of 0.9988. Now, YCO2 is 0.9988. Ito yung ating XCO2. Question? Do you have any question? Is our audio okay? Do you have any question? Nasusundan ba? We're doing the same thing. Ano? Yeah. So next is we have modified Reaulds law. No? Another question. So, eto, no? I hope nakuha nyo rin to sa ano, yung activity, ano? Nakuha nyo rin to sa PKM. So modified Reaulds law. So pag sinabing modified Reaulds law, instead na x sub I yung minumultiply sa p sat or sa p sub I star yung activity, no? So a sub I right here is the activity. A sub I. A sub I is the activity. Tandaan niyo pa yung concept ng activity. So parang ang sinasabi kasi dito sa chemistry, hindi naman daw talaga yung mole fraction yung imumultiply nyo sa P-saturated para makuha nyo yung P-supply. Kasi di ba nga, Reaulds law is a limit law. So in reality daw, yung activity daw, yung dapat imultiply sa P-supply star para makuha yung actual na P-supply. Kumbaga ito yung mas accurate na equation. No? Kaya nga lang, hindi naman kasi na-measure yung activity of I. So, ang ginagawa natin, kung napatandaan yung pang-PM, we have this equation. A sub I is equals to X sub I, ito yung mole fraction, ano? Times gamma. So, remember, gamma is the activity coefficient. No? Tandaan nyo pa yung gamma? So, sa PM, di ba, sinasabi pag ano, yung daw gamma palaging kasama ng x para matandaan yung equation na ito. Kasi nakakalimutan siya. So yung para matandaan nyo to, yung gamma palagi siyang kasama ng x. Okay? Do you have any question? Basically, ang modified Reaulds law, instead of x sub I, a sub I yung minumultiply sa e sub I saturated or e sub I star. Get e sub I. And then, ang in order to calculate a sub I from x sub I, mole fraction, we multiply this x sub I by gamma. Gamma is the activity. Ah, this gamma. Ah, the Greek letter. Let's proceed. Okay, so, minimize lang yung mga video para mabasa natin yung problem. So, this is example 10.3, you know? For the system of methanol, methyl acetate, the following equation provides reasonable correlation for the activity coefficients. So, in order to calculate gamma 1, ito, gamma 1, you just need to multiply A times X2 squared. Then, A is calculated using this equation. No? Meron dito ng temperature. Function na siya ng temperature. So, walang sinabing unit ng temperature, pero dapat meron yung specific unit ng temperature. Ano? So, kung ano na lang yung given, halimbawa kasi dito yung T natin. Ito na lang yung gagamitin natin directly. Ano to? Tapos, ln gamma 2. So, ang gamma 2 naman, this is used to calculate A2, activity 2. No? So, ganun din yan. A, baba kasi diba, pag A1, ang gamma palaging kasama ni X1. So, yung A2 naman, yun naman yung gamma 1. Yun naman kasama ni X2, si gamma. Okay? Susundan? So you can as you can see, you can use this equation to calculate gamma 2, and then you can use this first equation to calculate gamma 1, provided you have calculated A prior to that. Ano? Yung X naman, may given tayong X later. X1 natin is 0.25. Tapos binary din to. We only have methanol and methyl acetate. So X1 plus X2 equals to 1. Ano? In addition, the following Antoine's equation provide vapor pressure. So, dito naman natin kukunin yung isat natin. T1 sat, papalitan natin ito ng din temperature natin. Ano? Tsaka ito. So, makukuha natin yung P1 sat at tsaka P2 sat. No? Yung gamma 1. No? Where T is in Kelvin and the vapor pressure is in kilopascal. Kilopascal yung lalabas dito. Okay? Assuming the validity of example 10.5, calculate, you need to calculate the total pressure. So in order to calculate the total pressure, gagamitin natin yung modified Reaulds law. No? So yung modified Reaulds law, P1 is equals to P1 sat times activity 1. And then activity 1 is equals to gamma 1 times X1. Ano? All in all, ito yung magiging equation. Gamma 1 is gamma. Gamma 1 ganun lang. Ano? Then, ganun din sa P2. Ganun din sa ano? Hanggang P2 lang pala tayo. Then, pag meron na tayong P2, simply, yung P add T1 and T2. Susundan. Tapos yun namang Y1, ganun din lang yun. Pag may P1 na kayo, T1 divided by, okay? I guess, mas maganda dito na lang tayo mag-solve. So, I'm going to clear this up. Solve natin yung numerical. So, ito muna ng A. Let's try to solve A. So what we're going to do is we're going to substitute the temperature 318.15 Kelvin, and we're going to find A using your calculator. Get your calculator para hindi kayo mainit. 1.1071, ano? Question regarding letter A. Okay. So next is X sub I is equals to 0.25. Substitute natin dito yung A at saka X2. So X2 is, so therefore X2 is 0.75, ano? You agree? Substitute natin dito, ano? Ln gamma 1 is equals to 1.1071. Tapos X2 times 0.75. Let's try to calculate gamma 1. So 1.10 times 0.75 squared. Okay, tapos ilag. I have 1.864 yung gamma 1, ano? gamma 2. Ln gamma 2 equals to 1.1071 times 0.25 squared. So gamma 2 is 1.0716 ano? Okay, do you have any question? Okay. So next, let's try to calculate P1 sat. So P1 sat, we're just going to substitute the temperature right here, 380.15, and then calculate P1 sat. Okay, kilopascal. Ito naman, ito sa atin. So, 14.25. Ganun din, ano, this is temperature here is 385.64 na kilopascal. Okay. Okay, next let's try to calculate P1. So P1 is equal to P1 sat times activity 1, and then activity 1 is equals to gamma 1 times x1, di ba? P1 sat is 44.51 kilopascal. Okay, times gamma 1, 1.864. Tapos x1, 0.25. So P1 is 20.74, ano? Kilopascal. So do the same thing for P2. P2 is P2 sat gamma 2. Do you have any questions? 65.64 times 1.0716 times 0.7. Okay, so ano ang total pressure natin? Manawag na tayo para masaya. Total pressure natin. Alexis, anong total pressure natin? P is equals to Yes, that's correct. Ano? 73.4. So yan, ano, meron na tayong sagot. This is in kilopascal. What else? Y sub I. Okay, Y sub I. Y1 pala, Y1. So anong Y1 natin, Patricia? Anong value ng Y1? Two decimal places. Y1 is equal to 2. Remember, Y1 is P1 divided by P. Patricia. Hello, Patricia. Y1 is P1. P1 is this one. And then divided by P. Malabas sa calculator. Wala na. Is Patricia still around? Can you hear us? Jamie, ikaw, ano nakakalculate mo, Jamie? What about you, Jamie? Ano nakakalculate mong Y1? Yes, that's correct. Ano? 0.28. To the next problem. Do you have any questions regarding this problem? The next problem. Ito naman yung mga sagot. Ano? Y1 is 0.28 and then P is 73.5. Okay. Next is the equilibrium ratio K. So, equilibrium ratio K naman is equals to Y sub I over X sub I. Ito yung kanyang definition. Ano? Ito yung definition ng equilibrium ratio. Definition. Tandaan nyo pa rin yung concept ng definition. Pag sinabing definition, tanggapin nyo na yun. Ano? Parang postulate yan sa John. Hindi kailangan ng justification, hindi kailangan ng proof. Basta, yan yung definition ng equilibrium K. Ano? So, pag ginamit niyo yung concept ng K with Friot's law, you will arrive with this equation. Ano? So, you can calculate K using P sub I sat or P sub I star divided by the total pressure. Basically, combine niyo lamang yung dalawa. Ano? Yung Friot's law, di ba? Ang Friot's law, ano lang? P sub I equals to P sub I star, okay, times X sub I. Isolate niyo lang yung X sub I. Sub I is equals to P sub I divided by P sub I. Tapos meron pa kasi tayong Y sub I. So yung Y sub I naman, Y sub I, tandaan nyo is P sub I divided by P. So substitute lang itong dalawang equation dun. No? So, ang mangyayari dyan, K is equals to P sub I, ito yung Y, divided by P. Tapos yung X sub I naman, sub I divided by P. Or P sub I sat. Kaya sa ngayon, ano? Kakancel ko. So as you can see, with Riol's law, K is equal to P sub I. Punta pa sa taas, di ba? Divided by P. Any question with the justification of this equation? So yung problem natin, magka-calculate tayo ng K. Halimbawa sinabi na ano, it follows the Reynolds law. Magka-calculate tayo ng K. Pero actually sa ano, sa handbook, merong mga value din ng K, ano? Meron. Sa modified Reynolds law naman, so ito 'yun, ano, meron tayong gamma. Activity coefficient gamma times P sub I star divided. So pag sa modified Reynolds law, ang P sub I kasi equal sa, tandaan niyo ba, P sub I star times activity AI, ano? Pero yung AI, pwede natin palitan niya ng gamma times sub I. Yan, ano? So, pag in-isolate niyo yung X sub I, meron tayong P sub I divided by P sub I star. So, pag ginawa niyo ito, ginamit natin yung Y sub I equation. So, ang mangyayari, K equals to P sub I divided by P sub I star gamma tapos divided by P sub I yung sa Y, ano? Divided by P sub I. Ano na? Baliktad pala. Sorry. Baliktad. Gawa akong ano, Y over. Excited kasi mag-sarge. Dapat pala Y sub I yung nasa taas. So, ang Y sub I natin, ito ano? P sub I over P. Tapos ito yung sa baba. P sub I over P sub I star times. No? Kaka-cancel out ito. Tapos ito pupunta taas. P sub I star ito, times gamma. Ito yun. No? Divided. Okay lang? Do you have any question regarding the justification or derivation of ano K? With modified Reynolds law. Okay, let's proceed. Let's try to solve some problem using this equation. Yun. Tapos, syempre, ano, ito, common sense naman to, ano? The summation of y sub I is equals to 1. Tandaan nyo pa ba yung, ano? Parang ano to, yung separator, ano? Liquid vapor separator. Or plus distillation. Parang na-discuss to sa Chicalc. No? Sa Chicalc to din i-discuss. So, dun sinabi sa inyo. Anyway, common sense naman to. If you're going to add all the y's, no, all y sub i's, the sum is equal to 1. And then, if you're going to add all the x, no, the sum would be also equal to 1. So, parang ano lang yan. Parang binary, x1 plus x2 is equals to 1. No? Diba? Ganun din yan sa y. y1, pag binary, plus y2, equals to 1. Yan lang naman yung sinasabi ni Kimberly. Tapos, basically, ito namang summation of kxi is equals to 1. Kasi, di ba, ang definition natin ng k, y sub I divided by x sub I. So, therefore, y sub I equals to k times x sub I. So, the summation of kxi is equals to 1. Then, ano? Okay lang? So, ganun din dito, no? The same. If x1 plus x2 is equals to 1, so therefore, halimbawa, di ba, k is equals to k1, ano? K1 is equals to y1 over x2. No? So x2 is y1 divided by k1. The same thing for k2. K2 is equals to, I guess, I didn't get it. Okay, bak. So, K2 is equals to Y plus 1. Y2 divided by X2. So, Y2, X2, X2 is equals to Y2 divided by X2. Do you have any question regarding this part? And then if you're going to substitute this right here, this x1 plus x2 is equals to 1. Diba, what you're going to get is y1 over k1 for x1 plus y2 over k2. ba? Tama? So, yun. Ito din to. Ano? Summation of Y divided by K. Question? Any question? Yun. Ito yung sa handbook natin. Ano? You can get this in chapter 13. Page 10. No? Ito yung page na sa distillation. So, this is how you get the K value. Ano? You right here you have the pressure, and then right here you have the temperature, and then right here you have the list of substances. For example, you have ethylene, ethane. Ano masyado mabasa yung iba, ano? Tayo na lang sa page 10, ano? Octane, hexane, heptane, parang sunod-sunod naman, ano? Pentane. Okay? So basically, ang gagawin nyo lang is, halimbawa, given yung pressure, saka given yung temperature, just draw a straight line in temperature and pressure. Tapos babasahin nyo lang yung value. So for example, itong value na to for hexane, this is 30, halimbawa. So ang K ng hexane ay, no, this is how to get the K value. The equilibrium ratio using the handbook. Ano? Kapag nag-distillation naman kayo, we're going to solve more problems regarding the K value. So, ang K-value din ginagamit yan sa relative volatility alpha AB. Diba? KA divided by K. Yun lang yan, ano? Tapos ito ginagamit ito sa calculations. Diba? Gusto nyo magkumawa ng lambanog. Ano? Gusto nyo mag-compute. Paggawa ng lambanog. Ano? Para yung lambanog nyo masarap. Gagamitin nyo itong ano? Equilibrium ratio. Akalasing. Pag-chemical na gawa ng lambang. Matagal na ang chemical engineering sa Pilipinas. Yung mga nilunod natin matumusin gawa ng lambang. Nung college kami. Okay, so let's try this one. Ito, trial and error lang ata itong sample 10.4, ano? So for a mixture of 10 mole percent methane, 20 mole percent ethane, and 70 mole percent propane at 50 degrees Fahrenheit, determine the dew point pressure. Okay, kailan siya mag-evaporate? Okay, kailan siya magko-condense dew point, no? So mag-dew point yan pag yung summation of x1 is equals to 1. Ito pag dew point ang hinahanap, itong given, i-assume nyo y yan. Gas yan, ano? Gas yan. Tapos hahanapin nyo yung temperature or yung pressure, point pressure, yung pressure na yung summation of x niya ay magiging 1. Ano? Tapos pag bubble point pressure naman, so bubble point, ibig sabihin, ito naman, itong mga given na to, i-assume nyo naman na ano to. Liquid concentration. So x1 equals to 0.1. Tapos hahanapin niyo yung pressure wherein yung using the ano no, kasi pag may in-specify kayong pressure, makukuha niyo yung K value. Kasi given naman yung temperature, di ba? Ito 50 degrees Fahrenheit. So mag-specify kayo ng pressure, trial and error, tapos makukuha niyo yung K value. Tapos kakalculate niyo yung Y sub I kasi given naman yung X sub I. Diba? Tapos dapat yung sum nun magiging 1. Pag hindi 1, so mali yung inuulan yung pressure. Imagine nyo, trial and error tong problem na to. Ano? Let's try to see the solution nyo. So ganito yan. Ano? So manguhula siya ng pressure. Ito 100 PSI ay yung hula niya. Tapos hahanapin nyo yung K value sa handbook. Diba? Tandaan nyo pa yung chart natin. May given kasi na 50 degrees Fahrenheit. So ito, ano? So given yung temperature, tapos ito yung pressure na nula natin, ba 100, tapos babasahin nyo isa-isa yung K-value dito. Okay? Kapag nabasa nyo na isa-isa yung K-value, ito, so, ang Y sub I ay, ito yung assume natin, Y sub I is point, ito na yung value. Ito yung given, ano? Yung x sub I is y sub I divided by k sub I. Diba? Kasi remember, k sub I equals y sub I. So, ang x sub I ay equal sa y sub I. Okay? Kakalculate nyo to, tapos a-add nyo, so, yun, mababa siya. So, pag mababa siya, tataasan nyo yung pressure. Pag tinaasan nyo kasi yung pressure, tumataas din yung value ng y sub I. No? Tinaasan natin yung pressure, ito na siya. Tapos kuha ulit tayo ng bagong k sub I. Tapos calculate ulit natin yung x. Okay? 1.174. Mataas naman siya. So, babaan naman natin yung pressure. So, at 126, trial and error na, kuha na naman tayo ng bagong k sub I. Calculate na naman natin yung x natin. Ito yung ating x sub I. Bago. Add natin. So therefore, ang ating dew point pressure ay 126. Okay? One way. Ayoko naman yung mga trial and error. Ano mga papagawa sa inyo? Illustrate ko lang sa inyo kung paano kunin yung dew point pressure using the K-value. Question? Next, bubble point. So, ganun din, ano? Pag bubble point naman, kukulo. No? Bubble point is the same as boiling point. Diba? Bubble. Magkakaroon kayo ng bula. So, yung given, i-assume nyo na composition yun ng liquid. Okay? Liquid, full fraction yung pag bubble point ang ina. Okay? Tapos yan, simula tayo sa 380 PSIA. Kunin ulit natin yung mga K from the chart. Ito, mahirap magbasa nito. At nag-assume ka nga ng pressure. Multiply. Kasi di ba, Y sub I, K sub I is equals to Y sub I divided by K sub I. So, Y sub I is equals to K times X sub I. Ayun, ano? Okay lang? So, this is y sub i. Tapos, kinuha yung sum, 1.017. Ay, malapit na, ano? Hindi na siguro yan, eh. 380. Kita nyo yung final answer na ginagawa. Question? Ba yung sum niya ay? So, ang bubble point pressure ay 385. Okay? So, ang isang application niyan ay sa liquid vapor separator. No? Nakakuha niyo ba sa Chicalc yung liquid vapor separator? So, parang meron siyang isang column, isang container, tapos kinokontrol yung temperature at saka pressure dun sa loob ng container, ng equipment, ano? Tapos maghihiwalay yung vapor at saka liquid. Ano? Halimbawa to, toluene at saka hexane. No? 31% yung toluene, tapos yung hexane, 69%. So, pag ginawa nyo ang temperature niya ay 80 degrees Celsius, tapos 1 atmosphere, ang mangyayari, yung vapor nyo, yun, maghihiwalay sila. Ano? So, siyempre, ito, mas rich ito sa, I think, sa hexane, ito naman sa toluene. Ang toluene kasi ay 7 carbon, ano? Ang hexane, 6 lang. So, ito, mas rich ito sa hexane, ito mas ganun yung ano. So, manually, this is Aspen High Seas, ano? So, manually, tandaan nyo pa ba itong mga equation na to? Have you encountered this in Chicalc? Sa handbook, page 13-14. Have you solved problems using this equation from Chicalc? I know, hindi pa kayo nag-1, 3, 4, 5. Kasi sa 1, 3, 4, 5, anyway, kung hindi pa, so probably it's good to derive this equation. Ano lang naman to? So you can find this equation on handbook, no? 13, page 14 of chapter 13. Basically, to derive this, kayahin nyo lamang yung plus separator or plus distillation. Di ba ganito yan? Ano, meron kayong feed. Mapasok dito ang concentration ng Zay-Sabay. Yung Zay-Sabay na yun, ito yun, concentration ng feed. Ito yung vapor phase. So, ang concentration ng vapor phase, by convention, is Y-Sabay. Tapos sa baba, we have the liquid phase. Ang concentration ng liquid, by convention, is Y-Sabay. Ano ang ginagawa? Bakit ito sa, ano nakukuha? Bakit sa Calcrang? So, mag-go overall mass balance lang kayo. So, F equals to L plus B. Hindi niyo pa nakukuha, Jamie? Ito? Tapos, component mass balance. So, component mass balance is F, A sub I, B, L muna. L, B, B sub I, L. Yan, ano? So, ito muna, drive muna natin to sa X sub I. So, kung tingnan nyo yung equation, wala siyang L. So, ibig sabihin, tatanggalin natin yung L. So, ano, component mass balance. Tanggalin natin yung, kasi wala siyang L. Tanggalin natin yung L. So, ang L, papalitan natin ng F minus. So, this will become F C sub I equals to X I plus F minus B. Okay? Sunod, wala siyang Y sub I. So, papalitan din natin yung Y sub I. Gamitin natin yung equation na K equals to Y sub I. Wala siyang Y sub I. Palitan natin yung Y sub I na KXI. F Y sub I KXI plus F minus B times K. Yun. Tapos isolate nyo na yung X sub I. Ano? Pag in-isolate nyo yung X sub I, factor out nyo yung X sub I, you will have X sub I times B plus we have K times F minus B equals to F J I. Tapos isolate nyo yung X sub I. So what we have is X sub I equals to F J sub I divided by B plus K times F minus B. Oh, paano siya magiging kamukha nito? You just simply multiply the upper side with 1 over F and the lower side with 1 over F. Ang mangyayari, magka-cancel out yung F, like Zay sub I, para sa numerator. Yung sa baba naman, you will have BF, tapos ito magiging 1, ano? Ito magiging 1 of 1 minus. Tama ba? You will have the same denominator. Zay sub I, you have B over F, tapos K, plus K, times 1 minus BF. So, factor out BF. Factor out BF. Pag pinactor out mo yung BF, you will have K minus 1. Same lang. May minus dito eh. Do you have any question? One over one minus. So, copper out the app. Yeah, you're going to have K minus 1K, ano? Pinactor out natin yung BF. Say sub I, we're going to factor out BF. Ito yung una, 1 minus K plus K. Ulit, loop, dito, baba, L is equal to F minus B. Tapos A is equals Y sub I over XI. Y sub I sub XI. Ito yung Y sub I. So sinabi ko ito. XI. So I isolate X sub I. This is B. Correct? Tapos this one is A times F minus B. And then transpose. I multiply by 1 over F. So this one becomes 1 dF. Kumakita mali. Anyway, basta ganyan lang yung derivation yun, ano? Say I... Ah, yun. Sorry. I see. Ito baliktad. This is supposed to be B Y I. Sinauna ko yung B eh. X X L X I. So, B Y I L X I. B Y I F minus 1 F minus B X I. This is Y I. This is pinalitan mo na, this is ito yung papalitan natin. Ito, nandito yung AXI. Tapos, this is still A. This is lang A dito. Ano? This is XI. Yun yung nakita. Ito ba kayo? So, F say I. So, mali din to. Okay, so if you're going to factor out X sub I, we have F say I plus this is equals to X sub I tapos KB plus F minus B, you know? Tapos if we're going to isolate X sub I, we have F say I plus X sub I KB, KB plus F minus B. Just multiply 1 over F sa taas at 1 over F. Tama na ba? So X sub I equals to say sub I. Tapos we have KB F plus 1 minus B. Pag pinactor out ng BF, X sub I is equal to C sub I. This is KBF. You're going to factor out BF. As a KBF, ano? You will have K minus 1. Tama na siya. K sub I to, ano? Question? So, yun. Tapos ito, itong susunod na equation, just apply this definition, ano? Di ba, K sub I is equals to Y sub I times K times X sub I. So, kung Y sub I, it's just K sub I times X sub I. Ito yung X sub I. So, pag minultiply nyo lang ito ng K sub I like this, you're going to have Y sub I. Okay? Itong Y sub I. Ano? Multiply nyo lang ng K. K lang naman yung diferensya nung itong dalawa. K lang yung diferensya. So, basically, tapos ano lang. Summation of y sub I is equals to 1. So, pwede yung summation ito. Pag dew point yung hinahanap nyo, ano? Ay, pag bubble point. Pag naman dew point, ito naman yung isasum. Ganun lamang naman yun. And then, generally, we're solving B. B over F. Actually, we assume that F is equals to 1. So, we're trying to solve B. Pag sinolve nyo yung B, that's diffraction of the vapor. Tapos yung 1 minus B, that's the fraction of the liquid. Hindi nyo pa talaga ito nakukuha sa ano? Chicago. Anong oras na? 10:44 pa lang. 8:30 to 10, 10 to 11. Nandito pa kayo? Ilan pa ba tayo? Marami pa rin naman, lima pa. Hanggang wala na, hindi na talaga humabol yung iba. Okay, so let's try to use these equations. Ano? Nasa ano naman to? Nasa handbook. Page 14 sa handbook. Let's try to use this equation to solve some problem. Ito, no? The system, acetone, tatlo, ano? Acetonitrile, nitromethane at 80 degrees Celsius and 110 kPa has the overall composition Z sub I, say 1, 0.45, say 2, 0.35, say 3, 0.20. So assuming that Rolle's law is applied to this system, determine L, B, X sub I, and B sub I. The vapor pressure of the pure species at 80 degrees Celsius are P1 sat 195.75. Pag sinabing Rolle's law, di ba, na-calculate na, na-derive na natin yung kanina, ano? Pag sinabing Rolle's law, yung K natin ay equal sa PI sat divided by total pressure. Di ba? Ito yung, this is the same as P1 star divided by P. So we're going to calculate K using this equation. Tapos pag meron na tayong K, ang pinapahanap. B yung pinapahanap. Ano? So, 80 degrees Celsius, 110. This is approximately 1 atmosphere. Acetone. So, generally liquid to. Ano? So, these are X sub I's. Ang gagamitin natin is summation of y sub I. No? Kasi di yung acetone. Nakakita na kayo ng acetone, di ba? Medyo mainit. Anyway. Pero yung solution niya kasi in-assume niya na liquid itong mga to. Hindi sinabi na liquid yung feed. So, i-assume na lang natin na liquid yung feed. So, ang gagawin natin, at equilibrium, y sub I should be equal to 1. No? Summation of y sub I is equal to 1. So, ang gagamitin natin yung summation of y sub I is equals to 1. Tapos, ito, ang formula natin dito ay say sub I times K, diba? Divided by 1 plus B times B over F, F is equals, assume natin na F is equals to 1B, tapos K minus 1. This is K sub I, you know? So, isa-isa natin, ang gagawin natin, isa-isa natin i-calculate yung mga K sub I. Ito yung ating PSAT. Tapos, ito yung ating total pressure, 110 kPa. No? Yung P natin. Isa yan. So, after that, ito yung C sub I natin. Tapos yun, may K sub I tayo. Tapos, i-equate natin ito sa 1. Tapos, solve natin yung B. So, pag na-solve natin yung B, ito, 1 minus B is equals to 10. Tapos, in order to solve y sub I, ito, y sub I ito. No? Itong kc sub I 1 plus bki minus sub I. Yung x sub I naman, pag meron na kayong k, pag meron na kayong y sub I, tapos meron din kayong k sub I, you can easily solve it. Ganun lang, ano? Okay, yung picture ni Alex, ano parang... Okay. So, I hope we're still here. Okay, so let's try to solve this. I know I'm going to share a white. Okay. first, let's try to calculate the K sub I. Ano? Yung muna ng mga K. K1. So basically, equation natin ay P sat, P1 sat divided by P. So, for example, K1 is 195.75 divided by 110 in KPA. Yun ang po. We're supposed to get 1.77. Ganun din yung K2, ano? K2 is P2 sat divided by P. So this is 97.84 divided by 100. We're supposed to get 0.8. So, K3 naman is 50.32 divided by 100. Okay, so with this K value, we can now proceed with the summation of Y sub I. This equals to 1. And then this is the same as summation of K Z sub I divided by 1 plus P times K sub I. It's K sub I then minus 1. Just substitute everything, yung tatlo. For example, K sub 1 is 1.7795. Kasi multiply nyo lamang ito nung K sub I niya, 0.45. Yung unknown. Minus 1. Sunod is this one, ano? 0.88. And then finally, we have this one. Say sub I niyan ay 0.20. Okay, minus 1 ano? And then try to solve for using your calculator. You're supposed to get P is equals to 0.73. Pag nakuha nyo na to, so L is equals to 1 minus V. So, ilan ang L natin? Ito pa ba kayo? Syra. Ito pa Syra? Ilan ang L? Anong sagot sa L? Syra. Zaira Zofia. So, ang vapor fraction natin ay 0.7367. Ilan ang L? Arla Maribando. Zaira, 0.26. Minus mo lang naman, ano? 2.2 something ano. Okay, tapos yung ano naman, yung y sub i, halimbawa yung y1, ito lang yan. Ano, i-substitute lang dito yung p, tapos you're going to calculate y1. For example, y1 is simply equal to 1.775 times 0.45 divided by 1 plus 0.75. times 1.775 minus 1. So, yan yung y1. Kasi tinatanong yung y1 at saka yung x1. Ano? So 50% of 0.58. Pag ginamitan ko ng K1 again, 1.7795. So yun, ano, that's how you calculate y sub i. You just use this equation right here to calculate for y sub i. And then pag may y sub i na kayo, just use the ano, just use the k equation, di ba? K1 equals to y1 divided by x1. So ang k1 natin ito 1.7795. Ito yung composition sa vapor, itong y1, ano? Itong x1 naman, ito yung composition sa liquid. Y1 is 0.87. Tapos X1. So X1 is 0.87 divided by 1.7. Something like ano, 0.2859, ano? Question regarding this values, the L's. Then you will have several y1, so y2 and then x2, di ba? Ganun na. Questions regarding this problem? This is the last problem for chapter 10. Okay, so if you don't have any question, let's return to our PowerPoint. This time let's go to chapter 11. Yay, solution thermodynamics. So chapter 11 is ano, solution thermodynamics. So let's start with partial molar volume. Ano? Tandaan niyo pa yung partial molar volume sa PCM. As you can see, para review din lang naman siya ng PCM 2, ano? So partial molar volume, 'di ba? This is parang ang practical definition nito. Halimbawa, mag-a-add ka ng 1 mole of a particular substance to a solution, tapos mag-i-increase yung volume niya. So, basically, yung change in volume per mole of solution, yung partial molar volume, no? At a specific concentration. So, and then, mathematically, we define this as the partial derivative of B. B is the volume with respect to the number of moles, the number of moles added at constant pressure, temperature, and number of moles. No? Initial number of moles. N prime is constant. Yung ibang moles. Ano? nasimulan niyo pa yung ano, partial molar volume sa PCM. So we, you have an experiment sa PCM. Sinidiscuss din sa PCM. Okay? So let's derive the ano, the equation. Itong BA and A times plus BB and yung ito yung ano, di ba? Ito yung working equation natin. Kung tandaan nyo pa sa PCM, ito yung ating working equation. Ano? Okay, so parang ang simulang equation natin dito, i-assume lang natin na yung volume function siya ng number of moles of A at saka number of moles of B. Diba? Yan yung ating assumption. So, yung dB, kung pa kayo mag-unito, is dB divided by dNA, partial derivative of B with respect to N sub A at constant NB. Tapos i-multiply nyo ito ng parang pa kayo ito. Tapos partial derivative of B volume with respect to B NB at constant N sub A plus times D and D. Okay. Notice that this is itong partial derivative of B with respect to N sub A, constant NB, ito yung partial molar volume. Ano? So, we can replace this with B sub A. Right? Yan, kasi B sub J yung kanyang pangalan, tawag sa kanya. Ano? Partial molar volume. And also, this one is partial molar volume. So, mangyayari dyan, you have dB, BA, the partial molar volume of A, times dNA, plus the partial molar volume of A, times dNB. Tapos, para maging total volume, integrate natin. So, halimbawa, constant lang naman ito pag in-integrate niya ito doon. No? Pag in-integrate niya from 0 to N sub A, ito naman from 0 to B, so from 0 to N sub B, you will arrive at this working equation. B is equals to B sub A times N sub B plus B, partial molar volume of B times N. Okay? Ito yung ating working equation. No? Ito rin lang yan. Ano? Pinasok ko lamang yung integral sign dito. Nasa ko lang, assuming na constant yung B sub A at saka B sub A at that particular condition. No? Yan. Kaya naging ganito siya. Ito na pala. Ito naman pala. Do you have any question? Ang ano kasi dito, dapat natatandaan nyo pa to. Dapat solid talaga yung, yan. Ito. From here, pag in-assume nyo na yung B is a function of N sub A and N sub B, dapat ito, matic na to. No? So, dapat master na master niyan. Dapat ano yan, pinagduldulan sa inyo sa PCM yan. Naintindihan niyo talaga yan, na-realize niyo na ito talaga yan. Ano? Yun lang naman yan. Pinaka-basic yan. Tapos if we define yung partial derivative of P with respect to N, N sub J, N sub A, and N sub B. So, that's a partial molar volume and then represented by P sub A or B sub B. Ito na yung kasunod. Tapos we have this work. Ito lang naman yung gagamitin. Basically, what this equation is trying to say is, pag minultiply nyo yung partial molar volume ng A sa number of moles of A, tapos yung partial molar volume ng B sa number of moles ng B, makukuha nyo yung total volume ng solution. No? So, kung natatandaan nyo pa sa PCM lab, halimbawa, meron kayong 100 ml ng water, tapos meron kayong 100 ml ng ethanol, pag pinagsama nyo yun, you're not going to get 200 ml of solution. No? Generally, you will get a lesser amount of solution. Kasi nga, because of the partial molar volume concept. No? merong space na na-occupy, merong mga empty space sa liquid water na na-occupy ng ethanol, kaya lumiliit yung volume. Tapos, in order to predict the volume of the solution, ginagamitan natin ang partial molar volume calculation. Yung partial molar volume mathematics. Tandaan nyo pa? Anyway, so let's illustrate that in a problem. So let's try to solve 11.3, example 11. So the need arises in a laboratory for 2,000 ml of an anti-P solution, consisting of 30% methanol and water. Okay? So what volume of pure methanol and pure water at 25 degrees must be mixed to form the 2,000 cubic centimeter of antifreeze? Kasi nga yung methanol ay solute, you know? So once you add a solute, mas bumababa yung freezing point ng water. Also at 25 degrees. So partial molar volume for methanol and water in a 30 mole percent methanol solution and their pure species molar volume both of 20 degrees Celsius are, so this one is the partial molar volume. Yung may bar, ano, this is the partial molar volume. Ito yung partial molar volume ng methanol, ito yung partial molar volume ng water. Tapos itong B1 na to, ito yung molar volume. This is the molar volume of pure water. No? Ito yung sa solution. Ito yung sa solution. Partial molar volume, ito yung pure. Okay? So, kumbaga, halimbawa, may 1 mole of water ka, pure water, pure methanol pala, 40 ml, no? 40 point something ml. Pag sa solution, 38 na lang siya. Ano, lumiliit. Ang pure water, 18 ml siya per mole. Pag pure. Pero sa solution, nagiging 17. Okay? Ang tinatanong dito, ilang ml ng pure methanol yung imimix nyo? Saka ilang ml ng pure water yung imimix nyo para magkaroon ng 2,000? Nabivisualize nyo yung problem? Okay, so you just need to set the equation. Ano? So ang unang equation natin yung sa partial molar volume. Diba, B is equals to B sub A, partial molar, H2O na lang, times number of moles of H2O. Plus B ethanol, methanol. So M na lang ano? M times N ethanol. So ito yung unang equation natin. Ano? So ang total volume natin ay 2,000 ml. So substitute natin ito. Ito yung sa water, 17.765. Tapos hindi natin alam yung number of moles initially. Ano? Tapos, substitute natin yung ito, 38. This is ml per mole, no? So, ml din yung lalabas. Number of moles. Yan. This is our first equation. Yung second equation natin, the one that relates water and methanol. Number of moles of water and methanol. So, 30 mole percent tayo, ano? So, the second equation natin is, halimbawa, 0.30% na methanol is equal to number of moles of methanol all over number of moles of methanol plus. Ito yung second equation. Okay, so basically just use the calculator, no? Two equations, two unknown. So itong second equation, pag sinimplify niyo yan, 'no? So simplify pa natin further. Transpose natin yung methanol sa kabilang side. So 1 minus 0.3. So 0.7 ano? 0.7 number of moles of methanol. Ayun, methanol ka. Tapos sa kabilang side, you have 0.3. Kaya na? Kaya na 'to, ito yung second equation. Yun yung first. Gamitin nyo ng calculator, two equations to ano, nakukuha nyo yung number of moles ng methanol tapos number of moles of water. Pag nakuha nyo na yung number of moles, i-multiply nyo na lang dito sa molar volume. No? Yun, makukuha nyo na yung ml ng water at saka ng methanol. Ganun lang naman siya. Tama?
nakuha? Sige. So, get your calculator. Magtatawag ako. The first equation natin is NH2O is 7.68 8.6 thousand. Second equation natin is 0.7. Ay, negative 0.7 yun ha. Careful. Negative 0.7. Okay.
So, ilan ang number of moles na
ilan ang number of moles ng water?
Sino?
Carla Marie Bando. Ilan ang number of moles ng water? Ilan lumalabas sa calculator? Carla Marie? Okay pa ba audio ko? Malinaw naman? Marinig niyo naman ako? Carla Marie, what's the number of moles of water? Wait for Carla. Tama lang. Subukan ko pa mag-post ng video. Pwede na rin naman. Ang ating finals. Cover to cover naman yung finals natin, guys. Ano? So, hindi ko pa alam yung schedule kung kailan pwede mag-post ng finals. Pero ang alam ko ang last day ng classes tomorrow. Kasi holiday na ang 25. Traditionally naman, hanggang dito lang naman talaga ang thermodynamics sa graduates, sa undergrad, ano? Ataka ako bakit. Bigla nilang dinagdagan. Tapos, naging apat na taon na lang kayo. Kayo yung unang batch ng 4 years lang, ano? Anyway. It's online pa. Mahirap talaga. At least, we were able to discuss the basic of solution thermodynamics. Question? Answer pala, Carla? Can you see the equation? Yes, 58.27. That's correct. Very good, Carla. You need 58.27 moles of water. What about the number of moles of methanol?
ano, yung pinakamaaga dito. Yan. Oh, si Aaron Paul, ala sa as. Aaron, ilan ang number of moles ng ano, methanol? Ilan nakuha mo? Mga Aaron Paul, ala sa as. Ilan ang number of moles ng ano, methanol? Wait lang muna. Try ko lang yung ano. Bago ako sa mga. Kaya mapipin. Ilan? Ay, sige. Wait lang. Meron pa naman tayo. Hanggang 11:30 naman tayo. 11:60. Ba 8:30 to 10:10. Yun, 24.97. That's correct. Very good. Very good, Aaron. Okay. So this is mole ethanol. And methanol. No? So what you're going to do, is you're just simply going to multiply this with the, kasi pure na yan, di ba? Multiply nyo lamang dun sa this one. Over this one. Itong molar, sa molar volume. Remember, this is, itong 38 is partial molar volume sa solution. Ito yung sa pure substance. Ito yung molar volume. So, i-multiply nyo lang. For example, yung methanol, 24.97, i-multiply mo lang siya ng 4.7. So, pag i-multiply nyo yung 24.97, volume ng methanol. Multiply nyo lang yung 24.97. Ano? Diba mole ito? Tapos multiply mo lang siya ng 40.727. Diba ito ay cubic centimeter per mole. Kukuha mo na yung ml or kakancel out yan, diba? So ang volume ng methanol na pure na gagamitin natin ay 1,000, around 1,016.95, ano? Mga 1,017 ml ng methanol. Okay? So, ilang ml ng water yung gagamitin natin? Ano? Austin, Jimenez, ilang ml ng water yung kailangan? Austin? Calculator? Around how many ml of water are you still around, Austin Jimenez? So ito yung methanol natin, 1017. What about water? Ilan yung volume ng water? Austin, nandiyan ka ba? Lean, tulungan mo na nga si ano, Lean Johnson. Yun. Yun, sige, wait. Sige, wait na lang natin si Austin. Very good, Lean. That's correct, ano? 1,053 ml. So do you have any question regarding ano, example 11.3? Wala. That's it for today. Okay. Almost time na rin naman, 11:09. So
finals natin is from cover, from the first topic na na-discuss natin na hanggang dito, resolution thermodynamics. So, do you have any concern? Last day of classes is tomorrow. Hindi ko alam kung kailan pwede mag-post ng final. So, paki-monitor nyo na lang, ano? Then, kung may mga complaints kayo sa exercises, paki-message na lang ako. Mas mabilis siguro sa FB na lang kung ako yung message. Pero tinetek ko rin naman yung mga messages na sa ano. Kaya lang, mas ano kasi, lagi nakabukas yung FB ko. May mga problema pa kayo sa things. Questions? Kung wala na, hanggang dito na lang guys. Babay na muna.